while achieving common prosperity has become the top priority for the Chinese government. The importance of tax reform has been increasingly mentioned. Recently, a publication made by President Xi has raised some concern among investors with regards to a potential tax reform. Ivan, what did President Xi say in his publication?
A mainstream government publication, Qiu Shi, recently published an article quoting from a speech of President Xi, with the title Consistently Promoting Common Prosperity. The major action plans he mentioned include 1. Creating opportunities for more people to get rich and avoid laying flat. 2. Increasing the training and compensation for skilled workers. 3. Opposing the disorderly expansion of capital and enhancing antitrust regulation. 4. Strengthening core values to promote spiritual wealth. And 5. Optimizing individual income tax scheme, advancing legislation on property tax, and expanding the scope of consumption tax collection.
What did the government mention consumption tax reform this time?
Consumption tax is only the fourth largest income source for the Chinese government today, accounting for only 8% of China's total tax revenue. The major tax income in China stems for value-added tax 41%, corporate income tax 21%, property-related taxes 11%, and individual income tax 7%. Out of China's consumption tax, 50% from tobacco, 35% from oil and gas, 10% from auto, and 3% from alcohol. Given its currently relatively low contribution, it's a natural move for the government to think about consumption tax reform as a source of additional tax income.
From your point of view, how will the government reform the current consumption tax scheme?
While we wait for the final details to be announced, we expect the government to seek ways to increase the consumption tax, primarily on luxury spending, which is in line with the government goal of common prosperity. Compared with other imported and China-made luxury goods, the 20% average tax rate on baijiu, cosmetics, and jewelry is lower than that on tobaccos, 51-65%, cars 14-56%, and watches 25-31%. Thus, the tax rate for these items are most likely to be increased. Last month, we sold our position in Moutai, the leading premium baijiu brand in China, based on concerns about the regulatory risks for alcohol. The HSE China Fund aims to hold the best 25 Chinese companies based on their valuation, inner strength, and relative attractiveness. We will continue to keep a close eye on the government's regulatory action and adjust our portfolio accordingly if needed.
That's it for today. Thank you for watching and hope to see you again in the next episode.